Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, I'll show you how to solve MCAT-style anti-log questions without a calculator. This video picks up from my last video where I showed you how to solve logarithm-based questions, and you can find this video along with my entire series on solving MCAT math without a calculator by visiting my website leiaforsci.com/MCATmath. In the last video, I showed you a trick on how to find a pH, pOH, or pKa value when given a concentration or a Ka. The trick showed you that when you have a number times 10 to a negative power, that power becomes your pKa, your pH, or your pOH. But what if now you're faced with a question where the actual pH, pOH, or pKa value is given and you're asked to find the concentration or the Ka? For example, you may be given a question that says, find the Ka of an acid whose buffer has a pH of 4.19 in a solution containing equal moles of acid and conjugate base. I'll cover the science portion of this question in my chemistry videos at leiaforsci.com/MCATchemistry. But for this video, let's focus just on the math. Since we're dealing with a buffer, we'll use the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation, which says that pH is equal to pKa plus the log of conjugate base over acid. You'll also see this written as A minus over HA. Given that we have equal moles of acid and conjugate base, or 50-50, whatever number we have for conjugate base is the number for acid, and that means we have a ratio of some number over itself, or 1. The log of 1 is 0, and that means this entire portion of the equation drops out, telling me that the pH is equal to the pKa. Knowing that the pH is equal to 4.19, which equals the pKa, we know the pKa is also equal to 4.19. But how do we use this to find the Ka value of this acid? 4.19 is not a clean and easy number to calculate, so let's break it down. The first thing you want to do is check how close your answer choices are to each other to see how much you can simplify and how quickly you can come up with the answer. Here's the equation we'll use. If pKa is equal to negative log of Ka, since log stands for log base 10, to solve for Ka, we have to have 10 to the power of negative log to cancel out, and that means we need 10 to the power of negative pKa. So the Ka value is equal to 10 to the minus pKa, which is equal to 10 to the minus 4.19. A nice and clean number like 4 would give us a Ka value of 1 times 10 to the minus 4. But we also have to account for that 4.19, so we're definitely looking for a number very close to 1 times 10 to the minus 4. If this is not enough to isolate your answer, you then want to find the range where your Ka will fall out. We'll take the number 4.19 and round it down to 4 and up to 5. A pKa of 4 has a Ka of 1 times 10 to the minus 4. A pKa of 5 has a Ka of 1 times 10 to the minus 5. That means the number we're looking for is somewhere in this range. But if this is still not enough, then you want to go back to the trick where I showed you how to recognize the different numbers that give you the different ranges. In review, if we have a number 0.1, we get an 8 times 10 to the minus x. And I put x instead of the number because if we have 4.19, our exponent will be a number times 10 to the minus 5. So if we had 4.1, it would be 8 times 10 to the minus 5. A number 0.3 will be 5 times 10 to the minus that power. In this case, if we have 4.19, let's round that to 4.2. Remember, on the MCAT, you're allowed to round because it will be close enough. If 0.1 gives me an 8 and 0.5 gives me a 5, then our answer has to be somewhere between 8 and 5. So all you have to recognize is that the number is somewhere between 5 and 8. So it'll be between 5 times 10 to the minus 5 to 8 times 10 to the minus 5. Even if we haven't narrowed in on a specific number, for the MCAT, this is close enough. In fact, punching 10 to the negative 4.19 in the calculator, I get an answer of 6.46 times 10 to the minus 5, which on the MCAT is close enough. If you want to narrow this down a little more, 4.19 is closer to 4.1 than it is to 4.3, and that means we'll be closer to the 8 than to the 5, as is evident by 6.46. This concludes my video series on MCAT Math Without a Calculator. You can find this entire series on my website at layupforsci.com/MCATmath. You can find additional MCAT videos, including physics, chemistry, biology, and organic chemistry, on my website, layupforsci.com/MCAT.
Are you stuck on a specific MCAT topic? I offer private online tutoring where I focus on your needs to strengthen your individual weaknesses. Tutoring details can be found using the link below or by visiting my website, layupforsci.com/MCAT tutor. Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, The MCAT Exam Strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at mcatexamstrategy.com. By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, mcatexamstrategy.com.